In this video, we're going to take a look at some options available to us in Autodesk Inventor to adjust the display of assembly components. Here I have a simple cylinder assembly, and I want to be able to see inside of it, so I actually want to hide this cylinder body. So there's a couple of different ways that I can go at this. The first thing that I can do is suppress it. I'll right-click on the cylinder body here in my model browser, then select Suppress. Notice that it's gone from the screen, and if you look over here in the model browser, it's grayed out and it has a line through it. So it is essentially not there. Another reason why parts might be suppressed is to help assemblies load faster. So if you have a very large assembly with lots of small fasteners, for example, you can suppress the fasteners and the file will be a lot faster to open. To unsuppress a part, I can simply right-click on it and deselect Suppress. We can also disable a part. I'll right-click on the cylinder body again, and this time I will clear the check from Enabled. This time you will see that you can actually see through the part. So unlike suppressing, the part is loaded in the memory, and you can see through the part. So this gives you an idea still of where that part was instead of completely taking it away. To bring it back, I can simply right-click on it and select Enabled. We can also go about this the other way. We can instead select the objects we want to show. So for example, let's say that I wanted to show this cylinder head and the piston rod, and I wanted everything else to disappear. I'll go ahead and select the items that I want by holding Control. Then I will right-click on one of them and select Isolate. That will hide all other components except for the ones that I selected. So once more, this might allow me to work inside of an assembly. Then, when I'm done, I can just simply right-click and undo my Isolate. There you have three ways to adjust the view of assembly components: Suppress, Enable, and Isolate.